ರ್ಯಾಲಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸಿ ಇವತ್ತಿನ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನ ಮುಂದಕ್ಕೆ ನಡೆಸಿಕೊಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಲಿಂಗಾಯತ ಸಮುದಾಯದ ಜೊತೆ ಇದೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಧರ್ಮವನ್ನ ಬೇರೆಯಾಗಿ ನಾವು ನೋಡಿಲ್ಲ ನೀವು ಮತಾಂತರ ಕಾಯ್ದೆ ತರೋದಾದ್ರೆ ಮತಾಂತರ ವಿರೋಧಿ ಕಾಯ್ದೆ ತರೋದಾದ್ರೆ ಈ ಪಟ್ಟಿಗಳನ್ನು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ನಾನು ಕೇಳ್ತಾರಂತ ತಾಂತ್ರಿಕ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆನ ನೀವು ಉತ್ತರಿಸಬೇಕು ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ಈ ಸರ್ಕಾರದವರು ಈ ಪಟ್ಟಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಂತವುಗಳನ್ನು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ಈಗಾಗಲೇ ಮುಸ್ಲಿಂ ಧರ್ಮ 2 ಬಿ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ ಬೌದ್ಧ ಧರ್ಮ ಕ್ಯಾಟಗರಿ 2 ಎ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ ಇದೆಲ್ಲಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಗಿ ಕ್ರೈಸ್ತ ಧರ್ಮಕ್ಕೆ ಮತಾಂತರವಾದ ದರಿದ್ರರು ಕ್ಯಾಟಗರಿ 1 ರಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅವರ ಸೀರಿಯಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ 95 जगत अत्युत्तम ज्ञानी डॉक्टर अंबेडकर अंबेडकर धर्मांतर मनुष्य धर्म दिन हुटबार धर्म आय्के
Which was tabled yesterday by the Karnataka BJP ruling government is unconstitutional, is undemocratic. When I say unconstitutional, undemocratic, it's very clear. The values of the constitution has not been upheld by the ruling fascist government. I would really condemn the attitude of the Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangha for dividing the people in the country on the grounds of religion, culture, tradition, people's customs. Highly unacceptable. There are so much of conversion laws. People who want forced into that conversion are being punished. But my question to the government of Karnataka and the Prime Minister of this country. Why there is direct effect against minorities? Go back to CAA, you are bifurcating. Go back to the NRC, you are bifurcating. Go to NPR, you are bifurcating. Demonetization, you bifurcated. Triple talaq, you bifurcated. Sabarimala verdict, you bifurcated. Now the anti-conversion bill, you are bifurcating. It shows what exactly you are trying to make this country. I think this is unacceptable. We don't compromise this on the grounds of fascist notion. If you are planning to divide the state and the nation, I take my objection as an activist, as a human being belonging to the plural country and the largest democracy. I condemn this. The government has to immediately withdraw this anti-conversion bill.
Will you fight it legally? Because many states are fighting against it.
The nitty-gritties will be discussed very soon. We all know the assembly has only the majority. The council doesn't have a majority. You know. If it is something going beyond the process of the assembly floor, yes, we will be going to question that before the Honorable Supreme Court and also the High Court of Karnataka.
Okay, how do you see this bill?
It's a waste of time. This was not required. Highly unconstitutional. It is against the rights. It's my personal choice. What I, how I dress, who I want to believe in. All these are personal choices. Okay, the government has to do other things. There are so many issues which it has to solve. So basically, elections are around the corner. They are trying to divide society, polarize society, and divert from real issues. They have failed miserably.
So who do you think is more the target, Christians or Muslims?
He is targeting the constitution, and with this, he is fooling everybody. He is fooling everybody. It's not about targeting. He is fooling everybody. They are saying that, you know, there is forced conversion. If there is forced conversion, there are umpteen number of laws existing with which they can book, they can take action if somebody complains. Nobody has asked, but they have brought this bill. And if somebody is inducing, if they are giving something, okay, you can still, you know, with all your proof, you can say people are giving these kind of things, and because of which people are converting. You can. What is administration doing? Police and all that, you can inquire and you can. Okay. However, this government which has come to power, they induced in 2014. They converted the whole of India. They told them that "Achhe din aayenge." It did not come. They said two crore jobs for youth. We don't know where those jobs are. They said the prices will come down. Okay, we've seen how the prices have skyrocketed. Okay, on every sector they have failed. Their promises, they induced. They said black money will come, it will benefit. Nothing. They have failed in all these issues. So they are diverting, they are polarizing the society. And also, there are so many MLAs in Karnataka who have switched parties. Are you telling me they just went? There is some element of inducement. Okay. Nobody is speaking about that. They should correct themselves. They should be morally, ethically right to speak about others. And there are umpteen laws. There is no need of new law. Just like the farmer's law fell down after a year, this also will not face the constitutional thing. It will fall down.
Okay. Do you think helping someone in Karnataka or India is a crime now? Because that's how it looks like.
See, people, whichever way, as humans, if somebody is in trouble, people will go out, all out and help. Okay? So, that is an inherent thing. Yes, people may be wary because of the laws now. Okay? Now they have made you realize that, you know, who you are speaking to, which community. Otherwise, it was a human being. I could reach out to my neighbor, you know. It didn't matter. So, this government has nothing. It has failed on all fronts. They can only polarize and divide society, and it's a shame.
You have been part of Mercy Mission, and we know at the time of COVID, I mean, the amount of guys you guys help, you know, by not knowing the religion, you guys have did a cremation. So what do you tell about, what's the message you guys gave at that point, but why can't the government understand now?
The government or the political class is surviving on such issues. For them to come back to power, They don't have a report card which will speak their good thing. The middle class is suffering so much. There are so many people who have gone down, become poor. The middle class is in such a position that they cannot not even ask. They cannot open up and ask. They are suffering. They are suffering because of the prices. There have been more than 6 lakh people who have left the country and gone. They have migrated. So this is the thing. So there is big failure. All these Achhe Din and all this is just jargons. They have failed miserably, and now they want to fight elections, okay, on a polarized pitch. They know that on development and on real issues, they will not stand.
What about our minority ministers? Don't you think they are raising their voice?
This issue is not about minority or majority. This is a constitutional issue. It is the rights of everybody. Everybody has to speak. Okay, if you look at historically, Baswanna converted, he came out, he did not like, and Ambedkar converted. Okay, so it is a personal choice one has to make. That's not what the job of the government is, what religion they are practicing or what God they want to bow down to. That is personal thing. Tomorrow the government may stoop to a level that they will say like, okay, tomorrow you all will cook beans in as the menu. That's not their job. That's a personal choice.